Hey guys, Raider here. Hope you're all doing great and having a fantastic day. So one of the most frustrating things about using the book cover keyboard with any of the Samsung tablets is this. Let me show you. Hello, my name is Brian. What do we have here, guys? I'll tell you what we have. We have nothing. We have no predictive text, zero spell checking, zero recommendations. We have nothing to help us along the way in terms of correcting our spelling. But until Samsung gets us an update, we do have a workaround. Let me go ahead and walk you guys through the steps so you can have an experience like this. Hello. My name with an extra E, auto-corrected. ISS, auto-corrected. Brian, auto-corrected. You see we have suggestions at the bottom. A toolbar full of shortcuts. We also have the ability to do voice input, insert emojis, change the layout, toggle the autocorrect features on and off. What I'm going to do, guys, is walk you through setting up the Microsoft SwiftKey keyboard. I briefly touched on this during the full review of the book cover keyboard, but I actually didn't demonstrate it, nor did I show you guys how to set it up. Let's go ahead and walk through setting this up. All right, so first you're going to open up the Google Play Store. Once you're in the Play Store, you're going to search for SwiftKey. You'll see it's the first one here. And what we're looking for is the Microsoft SwiftKey keyboard. Let's go ahead and install this real quick. This is free. All right, guys, it's installed. Let's go ahead and open it real quick. All right, so you see we have a few steps. We need to enable the SwiftKey keyboard, and then we're going to select it, and then we'll finish up the steps. So let's go ahead and do that. So that's going to take us to our general management keyboard list screen. You'll see here we have a list of keyboards that are installed, like the Samsung keyboard. I also have Gboard installed from Google. And you'll see we have a new option here, a Microsoft SwiftKey keyboard, and it's currently disabled. We need to enable it. Okay, and that'll take us back to this screen. Now you're going to select SwiftKey, so go ahead and click on that. And that's going to pop up a dialog box to switch your default keyboard. And I'll show you where that is later in the video too, if you want to switch back and forth between all your installed keyboards. So we're going to go ahead and pick it. We're going to go ahead and hit finish up. I elect not to log in. You can set up an account if you want to save your favorite keyboard layouts, and that'll be transferable to other devices. But for this demonstration purpose, we're just going to skip it. Choose not to share data. Installation successful. All right, and this takes us to the Microsoft SwiftKey settings. The most important settings for use with the book cover keyboard is under typing. You're going to want to click on that. In here we have some auto correction features already enabled, auto capitalize, cursor control, quick period, quick predictive insert. But the one I want you to pay attention to first down here is physical keyboard. Adjust the settings for your physical keyboard, that being our book cover keyboard. So we'll go ahead and click on that. And you'll see we have a bunch of options. Auto correct, quick predictive insert, which will pick the middlemost option that it selects. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn that on. Auto capitalize on, punctuation completion on. I'll leave the rest of the settings as they are. And back on the typing screen, I go ahead and turn on quick prediction insert. Turn that on. Now you can exit out of here. So I'm back to composing another email. We have this keyboard enabled, and you'll see it pulls up this full on-screen keyboard like this. It'll only do this a first time only. Go ahead and pick not now. And then you're gonna click OK. And then you'll go ahead and minimize this. And as you start typing, you'll see we're back to just having our bottom bar. Hello. My name, and it's auto-correcting. All right, lastly, guys, if you don't want to use this keyboard anymore, like for me personally, I kind of like the Samsung keyboard for when I'm doing on-screen stuff when I don't have the book cover keyboard attached, and I prefer having SwiftKey enabled so I can get this functionality when I have the book cover keyboard attached. Let me show you that real quick. It's super easy. You're just going to pull down, go to settings, scroll down till you get to general management. And then you're going to click on keyboard list and default. Go ahead and select that. You'll see all your available keyboards. We saw the screen before, but you're going to go up to the top here to default keyboard and you switch back and forth. We'll switch back to the Samsung keyboard. So we're all set. So if I go back to that email now and I start typing, you'll see we're back to the Samsung keyboard and I have no automatic corrections. So we're back to square one. All right, guys. So until Samsung addresses us and gives us an update to include it and make it work just like their on-screen keyboard, this is our workaround. It works pretty good. I mean, it gives you all the functionality you need and it's not too obtrusive. Every once in a while, you'll see the full screen keyboard pop up. Very rarely though, but when it does, as soon as you start typing, it just drops back down and you'll be back down to that single line. All right, guys. As always, thanks for watching.